Before we go into how non-merit employees should be treated relative to merit employees, let's make sure we know who we are talking about. First, we have probationary employees. Part of obtaining career service for merit status is passing a probationary period. This period is part of the selection process during which a supervisor has time to assess an employee's suitability for the job under the actual conditions of the job. Usually, pre-employment selection tools do a good job of producing job candidates who can perform the duties of the job. However, the probationary period is there so that if an employee is unable to do so, they can be dismissed prior to obtaining career service status. If an employee has misconduct or behavioral problems during the probationary period, HR generally recommends that you dismiss the employee if you would have disciplined a merit employee for the same misconduct. Again, this is a general recommendation and one size does not fit all, so make sure you discuss this with your HR field office. The other kind of non-merit employee is a person whose position is not part of the career service program. Agency heads and other high-level officials are in this group, as well as temporary employees and others who were hired into career service exempt positions. Several agencies are made up almost entirely of career service exempt personnel. Employees in these positions should not be treated as merit employees, but they may still be disciplined. Rather than giving the employee formal due process with a notice of intent to discipline, giving an opportunity to respond, and only then imposing discipline, discipline may be imposed on a career service exempt employee with a single notice. The employee will not have an opportunity to respond and has no avenue to appeal the action. Such actions require consultation with your HR field office, just like discipline of merit employees. As I mentioned, the due process principles we discussed early on do not apply formally. However, giving employees adequate feedback and notice about what is going to happen if they fail to meet performance standards is a good idea under any conditions of employment. The observation, expectation, warning pattern is still available when dealing with non-merit employees. Remember, this pattern will diminish argument and allow you and your employee to get right to the heart of the issue quickly when used correctly. As this is not a formal procedure associated with merit employees, it will be useful with any employee. Although non-merit employees cannot use the grievance and appeals system and are not entitled to due process, there are still some ways the employer could find itself in hot water for actions against its employees. The best defense for any of these is to have well-documented evidence to show that the decisions made in each circumstance was reasonable. At the end of the day, you should still provide non-merit employees with appropriate feedback, especially if their performance is substandard. The feedback will either help the employee self-correct or start laying the groundwork and documentation to show that your decision to discipline or dismiss that employee was reasonable. You just have to remember that these employees are not merit employees, so don't administer discipline with a two-step process. Just impose discipline right out of the gate. And do not administer a performance improvement plan. You might do something similar that lets the employee know what they need to do and how long you will wait for them to do it before further action. Just don't call it a performance improvement plan. By way of review on all 8 topics we've discussed in this training, I hope you can see just how valuable your HR field office will be to you when you have problems with employees. Please consult with them and use their expertise to help solve your problems in a way that will not get overturned later. Make sure you are upfront with your employees by making sure they have adequate notice of conduct and performance issues in a timely fashion. Do not ignore the importance or significance of these decisions. You are considering actions that will have a permanent effect on your employee's work history, while at the same time making the best decision for your agency. This is a delicate balance and deserves your best effort and attention.